what is graph, why it is said as representing the geographical relationship, and how it is mathematically represented in the way g equal to v comma e, what is v and what is e, and how it is diagrammatically represented from the diagram, how v is defined and how e is defined, what is v and what is e, depending on the edge e, how the graphs have been classified as directed, undirected, weighted, unweighted, example for each kind of graph, diagrams for each kind of graph, and terminologies that are followed in the graph, path, then cycle, based on the cycle, the types of graph may be of cyclic graph, non-cyclic graph, that is acyclic graph, a degree, especially with the help of a directed graph, the degree is intern divided into in degree and out degree, that is number of edges coming to a vertex, number of vertex, number of edges going from a vertex, how the, so most important, how the graph is represented inside the memory, inside the computer memory, how it is represented. Diagrammatically, it is represented like that, and mathematically, it is represented like that, but inside the computer memory, how it is represented. So in general, there are two kinds of representation. One is array, another one is pointers. Array representation of a graph is called adjacency matrix. Pointer representation of graph is called adjacency list. And the concept is very easier when you go for representing any graph. That is, a graph is given to you. Then you have to mark both the column as well as the row by the node number. Then according to the number of, according to the presence of edge, you have to say 0 or 1. If a edge is there, then you have to show 1. If you are not, if you no edge is present between any two nodes or any two vertex, then 0 is presented. In case, if the graph is a weighted graph, say for example, this graph is having somewhere weights like 4, this is 2, this is 1, this is 2.3, like that, that means then into from 0 to 1 there is a path, and that path having a weight value of 2.3. Abdina, what you have to do is 0 to 1 this value. So instead of 1, what it signifies? 1 signifies presence of path. Of course, path is there, but what is the cost of the path? 2.3. So instead of 1, you have to print the cost matrix. You have to print the cost value associated with the edge. So that matrix will become a cost matrix, adjacency cost matrix like that. So that's the idea that we have seen in the last class. Now coming to today's topic, graph traversal. So the traversal word we had already seen in the last three topic. What do you mean by traversal is? So traversal is task of visiting all the nodes, visiting all the nodes. So since it is a graph traversal, visiting all the nodes of a graph. There are two traversal of a graph. One is a breadth first traversal, another one is a depth first traversal. So when you take the breadth first traversal, strictly speaking, you by the name, it will be traversed breadthwise. By the name depth first traversal, it is the every node is visited depthwise. Depthwise, that is priority is given in the depthwise direction. So, in order to implement the breadth first traversal and depth first traversal, you need to have some kind of data structure so that after traversal, you need to produce the output. So, for breadth first traversal, queue data structure is used, and for printing the output of the breadth first traversal, array is used. Likewise, for depth first traversal, stack is used for traversal purpose, and for printing in the traversed node or visited node, array is used. So how to traverse with the help of breadth first traversal? Whatever it is, that is, whether it is a breadth first or it is a depth first, you should start with the one node and make that node as a visited one. So in this case, for this given graph, 0 is the one if I took as the one which is visited first. So I have to copy the 0 in the array first, whether it is breadth first or search first, the 0 is copied here. So that's why, so the at the back of the queue, that means 0 is made as the visited one. After that, what you do is the edges arising from the node 0 or the nodes connected to the node 0 are taken and it is pushed at the top of the stack if it is a depth first traversal. That means 1 is coming here, 2 is coming here, 3 is coming here, like that. That is when I drew line with the help of this. Yes. So 1 is printed here, 2 is printed here, 3 is printed here. If you make 0 as the visited one first to start with. Likewise, when you take the breadth first traversal, if you start with the 0, that is you have to start with 0, 0 is printed as a, then the back of the queue. See, if you say back of the queue, there is no pointer called back. Instead, we have the pointer called rear. Since one pointer is called front, this pointer may be otherwise called by some context back pointer, front pointer, back pointer, like that. So rear, so that is back of the queue. So you have to insert 1, 2, 3. So likewise, you should do this task repeatedly after fixing the node. You know, 0 has been visited, then what you have to do is you have to choose another node 1. So if you choose 1, what are the other nodes to be entered into queue or entered into stack or printed in the array? Likewise, the process goes on. Let me explain this with the further with respect to the given exam. See, this is the given graph. So I am going to do breadth first traversal. So I have to imagine a front pointer as well as a rear pointer. To start with, the node 0 is pushed into the side, is printed in the array, and the adjacent elements of 0, that is 1, 2 and 3, these three elements are printed in the queue. These three elements are printed in the queue by using the pointer rear. So for rear originally it is here, then after by for enqueuing the element 1, rear comes here, and for enqueuing the element 2, rear comes here, and for enqueuing the element 3, rear comes here. So that's the first stage. Is the 2. Next, among the three, that is 0 is visited, among the three, what I have to take. Since in the queue, what is printed? One is printed. So the front pointer is moved, and the 1 is removed from the queue, and it is printed in here. So likewise, the front pointer is moved one position up, and the data elements in the queue is dequeued, and it is printed in the corresponding array. So once you said that, if you come to the point 2, if you visited 2, then you need to place another element called 4, which is adjacent to 2, and you have to print that element in the visited array. So likewise, you go for breadth first traversal. So you keep on visiting the element and printing the element in the array for which the elements are visited. So the breadth first traversal order is 0 is traversed first, visited first, 1 is visited second, 2 is visited third, 3 and finally 4. So that is the order in which you have to visit the elements with respect to breadth first traversal. So first is 0, among the 0 you start with the 1, then 2 and 3. So likewise the breadth first traversal goes finally with the 4. So these are the applications of breadth first traversal. So breadth first traversal is having wonderful application. See, your GPS navigation system, and you in computer network, peer-to-peer connection, finding the shortest path, minimum spanning tree, the crawlers. What is meant by crawler? So it is a kind that is a concept that is used in search engine when you are looking for some pages. So those are the stuff that is used, the concept of breadth first search. Next, coming to depth first search. So in depth first search also, you have to start in the same way. So here, 0 is printed, 0 is printed. Next, you have to see through the element that is the direction of depth. So for that, first 3 is pushed, 2 is pushed and 1 is pushed. Now, if you want to print the element, then it is popped up, and the popped element are printed in the visited array. Pop delimit delimit are printed in the visited array. So like popped out, Greece popped out. Now if you want to pop the element 2 and 2 has some element, so that 4 is printed, pushed into the stack. So when you are going to remove the element, so 4 is printed. So this is the answer for depth first answer. See the difference between breadth first and depth first. So breadth first, the output is 0, 1, 2, 3 because of the fashion it is visited. So it goes in this direction for printing the next element adjacent to 0. That's why after 0, the pushed, the enqueued elements are 1, 2, 3 in the queue. Likewise, in the depth first traversal, it is visited in this direction. First this one, second this one, and third this one. So far, 3 is pushed into the stack. 2 is pushed in the tag and 1 is pushed in the tag. So if you visit 3, if you visit 1, the adjacent element is 2. So next it should be visited is 2. If you visit 2, the next adjacent element is 4, which is not explored. So 4 is pushed into the stack here. 4 is pushed into the stack here. So when you are popping the element, the arrangements are like this. 0, 1, 2, 4. 0, 1, 2, 4, 3. And in terms of depth first traversal, whereas in terms of breadth first traversal, it is 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, right? So this is the way you need to understood and you need to traverse each node of the graph using breadth first traversal as well as depth first traversal. So the applications of depth first traversals are, again, the important topic is topological sorting. Here also to check whether the graph is bipartite or not, bipartite. Bipartite or not is a kind of graph which is having two entities. So here also you have the same application, whether the graph is bipartite or not. And another example is detecting a cycle, whether a graph having cycle or not. Cycle, what do you mean by cycle? If you start from your node and if you ends at the same node, then it is said to be a cycle. And finding strongly connected components. These are the topic we are going to see in the later part of the unit. What is going to be a strongly connected component, or is going to be a weakly connected component, what is going to be articulation point like that. So also it is used for finding the path from one node to another node or some other nodes. The depth first search can be used for finding the path. And another most important example is solving puzzles. So in gaming also, so the depth first search is used very popularly for some kind of solution to provide the challenge for the game user. Next, so I think with this breadth first and depth first is not that much. You can refer some other material for additional learning. Next important thing is topological sorting. So topological sorting is also called by the name topological ordering. See, if you could see the application of graph, then you may see to that this node can also represent a task. So when you are going to design a compiler or an operating system or any function executor, it may be loaded with some task. But it is the machine to decide which task you should take first and execute it, and then followed by which task. So that way, you need to order the jobs. You may heard about some term called, not now, maybe in future you heard about some terms called parallel processing, cloud, grid, like that of things. So in which you need to, your task is, major task is like scheduling, job shop scheduling, those kind of steps are there. For which you need to do a kind of ordering, so that that order only you need to process the task or you need to carry out the job. So in that way, the topic is called as topological ordering. So it is not sorting. So it is not a general sorting. So generally, what do you think about what is meant by sorting? Sorting is whenever a list of numbers is given to you, and your task is to arrange the numbers in a increasing order, if it is ascending order, otherwise a descending order, it should be the decreasing order. That is kind of sorting everyone has to say. But here this topological sorting is not that kind of sorting, but it is an ordering of elements. So with the graph, when a graph is when the task is represented, or when the set of jobs, when you set up task or when you set up jobs are represented like this kind of graph, then what kind of adder a machine or a person has to conduct in order to execute the task, in order to execute the job. So you to proceed with the topological sorting, the first condition is the graph should be a dynamic graph. This is the first condition. See, what is my dynamic graph? Presence of arrowhead, right? Which gives from here to there, from here to there, not from here to there, right? And acyclic graph. Acyclic graph. What if you have acyclic graph? See, here there is no cycle. If there is an arrowhead like here, like this, means, see, the graph is like this, like here on arrow, here on arrow means from 3 to 0, if this arrow is not like this, here, from 3 to 0, I have a connection. From 1 to 0 to 1, I have a connection. So from 1 to 3, I have a connection. That it means a kind of cycle. Some cycle is there, right? So if that is the graph, then the topological sorting is not possible. Topological sorting is not possible. You cannot do topological sorting at all. So what do you have to do is, before doing the topological ordering, you have to check whether the given graph contains arrowhead or not. If it casts arrowhead, then you mean that it is a dynamic graph. Then you check whether any cycle is there or not. If there is a cycle, it is not at all possible to do the topological ordering. Otherwise, the topological ordering is possible. So what is the topological ordering trying to say to us is, whenever you have a set of edges, which is of the form, edge capital E equal to U comma V, U comma V, U comma V. That means there is a edge, there is a node U, there is a node V, and the direction is from here to there. So here, what you should process first? You should process this job first, then only this job. So that is the condition here. So if you look at it, say for example, U and V. If you calculate the degree, what is the degree of, what you calculate the degree, that is calculate the in degree, the in degree of U is 0 and the in degree of V is 1. So what is this definition is saying is, this definition is saying that if you have a graph and if you are going to choose a two vertex U and V, such that U and V are connected, there is an edge between U and V, and if that direction is between from U to V, then what task or what node you should process or you should order first is U, followed by V. So that is the property that you should follow for doing the sorting and the ordering property. So that is what you should do. So for a given graph, definitely if the graph is a directed or a graph, acyclic graph, so generally it is called as a DAG. When you refer any book, it is simply called as DAG graph. So what is a DAG? Directed acyclic graph, DAG. So when you are provided with a directed acyclic graph, so what you have to be keep in mind is, at least you should have one topological ordering is possible, at least, and at the maximum you can have any number of ordering is possible. See, for this graph, the topological ordering may be answer for the topological sorting may be this one, or the answer for the topological ordering may be this one, because in order to do the topological short ordering, you have to choose a node first. You have to choose a node first in order to start with. So what node I have to start? So for the given graph like this, you should assume or you should take a node which is having zero in degree. So for that, first you should calculate the in degree for all the nodes. In degree for all the nodes. For the node 5, the in degree is 0. For the node 4 also, the in degree is 0. For the node 2, the in degree is 1. For the node 0, the in degree is 2. For the node 1, the in degree is 1. No, so node 1, the in degree is 2. This is 1 degree, this is another degree. For node 3, the in degree is 1. So now you say, in order to start the topological sorting, what is the node I have to start with? Either I have to start with the 5 or I have to start with 4. So there are two answers are possible. If I start with the 5, what is this, I will get it as an answer. In case if I start with the 4, this I will get it as the answer for the topological sorting. So that is what the idea that you should remember before carrying out the topological sorting. I explained it with the example how to implement it. So in order to implement the topological sorting, so when a graph is given to you, you should convert the graph as an adjacent list. So how to create adjacent list? First, you need to mark all the nodes 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So it is a linked list concept, right? It is a kind of linked list. From 0, how the connections are there. From 1, how the connections are there. From 2, how the connections are there. From 3, how the connections are there. Like that, you have to assume. From 0, is there any other direction goes to any other node? No. So that is 0 is null node. From 1, is there any other node goes from 1 to any other node? No. So that means it is null node. From 2, if you see that from 2, it is going to 3, right? From 2, it is going to 3. So that's it. From 2, there is only one connection is there. That is 3. From 3, here also there is only one connection. That is 1. So either you can represent it like a box, linked list box like that, or you can simply wrote like this form. It is a simplified form. So for practical implementation of the topological sorting, first of all, what you need is you need a adjacency list. You need an adjacency list like this, and you need an array. First of all, you should make all the visibility value of every node as a false one. That is for programming purpose or implementation purpose. Ellame initial enna irukka podu zero va irukka podu, right? Ipo andha function call pandra topological sort abindra function call pandrom. Idha andha function call pannumbodhu that is a function that is repeatedly called. So it is a kind of function called recursive function. Adha what element we are passing it? Zero endra element pass pandrom. So zero endra element em pass pandrom? Why we start with zero? Why we should start with zero? Because you have any other idea? So it is good to start with the node with the 0 degree. Otherwise, you can start with the numbering property according to your convenient. Because the node that is given here is 0. The 0 doesn't have any other child nodes, so 0 is given first, then 1 is given first. So whatever the given thing is first, if there is no more recursive call, then that mean is the list is empty, that the node is printed. So likewise, the process is going on for every node that is visited, and the topological ordering from the stack is printed from the element like this. So now here, when you want to print here, the top element will go here like top here like this is top. So originally the top is here. So the top element is here. So now the top pointer is incremented. 0 is printed. Now the top pointer is incremented. 1 is printed. Now the top pointer is incremented. Another is printed. Likewise, it goes on. Now the top end. Now if you want print all the element from the star from the top to bottom, what is the first element that is printed? 5. What is the next element that is printed? 4. What is 2? 3, 1, 0. So this is the output from the implementation. Let me check with the property. So this is the property by handover procedure. So this is the graph given to you. First of all, you should calculate the degree. For 5, how many in degree? 0 in degree. For 0, how many in degree? 2 in degree. For 4, how many in degree? 0 in degree. For 2, 1 in degree. For 3, 1 in degree. For 1, 2 in degree. So from which node you have to start? You have to start with the node with the 0 degree. So you can start with either 5 or you can start with either 4. Let me take, I started with the 0. But 0 is the start. So 5 is the first node, 5 is printed. Right? 5 is printed. What do you do? In the link, disconnect. Once again, you calculate. So this is the graph. Now your graph is only this alone. இப்ப கிராஃப் கால்குலேட் பண்ணும்போது இந்த 1 க்கு வந்து இன் டிகிரி வந்து என்னது 2 க்கு வந்து இன் டிகிரி வந்து என்னது 0 2 க்கு வந்து இன் டிகிரி 0 4 க்கு இன் டிகிரி 0 4 க்கு இன் டிகிரி 0 ரைட் இந்த 0 க்கு இன் டிகிரி 1 இதுக்கு முன்னாடி 2 இருந்துச்சு இப்ப அதை எடுத்து விட்டதனால இந்த எட்ஜ் டிஸ்கிரேட் பண்ணல இப்ப வந்து 2 க்கு இன் டிகிரி வந்து 1 நவ இந்த 2 க்கு இன் டிகிரி 2 3 க்கு இன் டிகிரி வந்து 1 ரைட் நவ வாட் இஸ் which is having 0 இன் டிகிரி 4 or 2 so நீங்க எது வேணாலும் பிரிண்ட் பண்ணலாம் 4 பிரிண்ட் பண்ணலாம் இல்லனா 0 பிரிண்ட் பண்ணலாம் so நான் என்ன பிரிண்ட் பண்ண போறேன் அப்படினா வந்து 4 பிரிண்ட் பண்றேன்னு வெச்சுக்கோ சோ பிரிண்டிங் 4 சோ பிரிண்டிங் 4 so 4 பிரிண்ட் பண்ணனே what I have to do I have to remove this line I have to remove this line இந்த ரெண்டு லைனை ரிமூவ் பண்ணு ரிமூவ் பண்ண இப்ப கிராஃப்ல இது மட்டும் தான் இருக்கு கிராஃப்ல எது மட்டும் தான் இருக்கு இது மட்டும் தான் இருக்கு இந்த போஷன்ஸ் மட்டும் தான் இருக்கு சார் நான் 4 பிரிண்ட் பண்ணல சார் நான் 2 பிரிண்ட் பண்ண போறேன் சார் of course possible நான் 2 பிரிண்ட் பண்ண போறேன் சார் அப்ப 2 பிரிண்ட் பண்ண என்ன பண்ணிரணும் இந்த எட்ஜ் மட்டும் ரிமூவ் பண்ணிரணும் இப்போ நான் 4 பிரிண்ட் பண்ணனால இந்த எட்ஜ் ரிமூவ் பண்ணிருக்கேன் இப்போ என்ன இருக்கு இப்போ கால்குலேட் பண்ணுங்க 0 இஸ் ஹேவிங் 0 இன் டிகிரி 0 இன் டிகிரி 1 இஸ் ஹேவிங் 1 இன் டிகிரி 3 இஸ் ஹேவிங் 1 இன் டிகிரி 2 இஸ் ஹேவிங் 0 இன் டிகிரி இப்போ ரெண்டு இன் டிகிரி இருக்கு என்ன 0 and 2 இதுல நீங்க எது வேணாலும் பிரிண்ட் பண்ணலாம் லெட் மீ பிரிண்ட் 0 0 வா நான் பிரிண்ட் பண்றேன் 0 வா நான்0 இது வந்து 1 இப்போ பிரிண்ட் பண்ண வேண்டிய எலிமெண்ட் வந்து என்னது 3 பிரிண்ட் பண்ண வேண்டிய எலிமெண்ட் வந்து 3 because the 3 is having the 0 degree இப்போ 3 ஐ பிரிண்ட் பண்ணியா இதோட எட்ஜ் ரிமூவ் பண்ணிடு இப்போ இன்டிகிரி கால்குலேட் 1 க்கு வந்து 0 அப்ப 1 so this is the one kind of topological sorting or ordering அப்ப நான் எனக்கு வர ஜாப் நான் எப்படி process பண்ணேன் first 5th job process பண்ணி 4th job process பண்ணி 0th job அப்புறம் second job அப்புறம் third job அப்புறம் first job சார் இதுக்கு ஒரு மாதிரி இருக்கு சார் ஆன்சர் இங்க ஒரு மாதிரி இருக்கு சார் 5 4 2 3 1 0 yes of course this is also correct answer because why because in a note it is already said that there can be multiple topological sorts of g multiple topological sorts of g what you should think about before doing topological sorting whether it is a direct graph and it is a acyclic graph this thing you should check so minimum one topological sort is possible maximum you can any number so இங்கே பாத்தீங்க அப்படினா நான் 5 ல இருந்து ஸ்டார்ட் பண்ணி 4 நான் சாய்ஸ் பண்ணே அப்படினா செகண்ட் நோட ஒரு ஆன்சர் கிடைக்கும் 5 ல இருந்து ஸ்டார்ட் பண்ணி 2 வா ஸ்டார்ட் பண்ணா ஒரு ஆன்சர் கிடைக்கும் இங்கே எனக்கு ஒரு டைப் வந்து 0 வா பிரிண்ட் பண்றதா இல்ல வந்து अदर எலிமெண்ட் பிரிண்ட் பண்ற சோ இந்த மாதிரி ஒவ்வொரு டைப் லீ நீங்க என்ன சாய்ஸ் பண்றே தட் இஸ் கரெக்ட் why it is correct because that node is also having 0 as the indigiri so that's why it is saying that is correct and it can be possible for many answer so the purpose you should understand is if you have a vertex u to v the u should be processed first and v should be processed second why because from u only the v is going that means u is having 0 degree and v is having 1 degree 1 in degree so the 0 in degree node has to be processed 0 in degree has to be processed that is what so you always choose the vertex with the 0 in degree that means a vertex with no incoming edges so this is what topological sorting is about so when you want to do a manual way of illustrating the concept this is work out this will be work out no some question has been asked like this implement topological sorting with the stack abina you have to write this along with the program so this is the programming this is the implementation idea of implementing the topological sorting using stack whereas the one that is drawn by means of removing the edges once it is printed is the way in which you have to do it manually when you are explaining the concept right so that is the two way you need to do the topological ordering but the answer is not uniform for everyone based on the decision you have to choose the answer may vary and the answer may go different because it is widely accepted that any number of ordering is possible or many number of orderings is possible for a given graph only thing you have to ensure it the graph should not be a cyclic graph right so if it is a cyclic graph you would definitely say that no answer is possible for the given graph in terms of topological sorting so that's what you need to give for the topological sorting so what are the applications of topology I already said to you that the major important task is scheduling up jobs It may be a job done by an operating system, or it may be a job done by any manager or administrator. So you need to do create a list of jobs and consider each job as a node, and you need to have a dependency connection among the jobs. That is, you need to view the job as a network, and you have to represent that network as a graph. Then if you apply the idea of topological sorting, then the topological sorting will give you the answer for scheduling of jobs. Not for the ordering of jobs, that is ordering of the formula cell evaluation also. So you need a spreadsheet. What do you mean spreadsheet? You know MS Office Excel, right? So in MS Excel, it is not only a ordinary software like Word, but it is a programmable software. You can give formula to evaluate like average, mean, or you can use it for pivot table. So for which also you have to use the spreadsheet also using the concept of topological sorting in order to evaluate the formula. So which formula should come first, then followed by which formula the second. So that is the order. So that order also can be used. So likewise, you can have many applications for topological sorting. Next, another important concept is biconnectivity. So biconnectivity is a very, 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 very important two-mark, biconnectivity. So what is meant by biconnectivity is, before that you should know what is meant by connected graph. So if a graph is given, so this is graph 1 and this is graph 2. This is graph 2. So what is the difference between these two graphs? Here all the vertexes are connected. So this is a connected graph. But here, this vertex is not connected, right? This vertex is not connected and this vertex is not connected. This is available as a separate one. You may treat this as one graph and this is another graph. And if you treat these two as a whole graph, then this should be one subgraph and this should be another subgraph. So this is a graph that is not a connected graph, but this is a graph that is a not connected graph, and this is a graph that is a connected graph. So in this connected graph, you need to define a vertex called cut vertex. So it is all say that cut vertex, or it is say that separation vertex. So in this given graph, say this given graph is a flight transportation network in US. So here, if you cut airport terminal here, that is, if you cut this node, the node cut particular one, enna aidum. So in the rendume thani graph aidum, PVD or node and LVG LGA or node. அப்ப இது ரெண்டுமே தனித்தனி தனியா ஒரு கிராஃபா மாறும், தட் இஸ் ஒரு சப் கிராஃபா மாறிடும். இதுக்கும் இந்த என்டையர் மித்த கிராஃபுக்கு சம்பந்தம் இல்லாத மாதிரி தனியா ஆயிடும். சோ In a graph, you have to identify or you have to see through a vertex or a presence of a vertex, and you should see that if you remove that vertex, whether the graph can be separated into two subgraphs. If the graph is created as a non-connected graph by removing that separation vertex, or if you remove that cut vertex, then it is said that that point, that node. So what is the cut vertex here? This ORD is a cut vertex. Next, you have to define an articulation point. So what is the articulation point? Is if you remove this one, what is happening? That graph will become two. So this is one graph and the entire other things are another graph. That means this graph will become separated from this graph. Will become a disjoint one. But I do not want to make that as a disjoint one. I always want to make as a joint one. So if you put additional root, then via this LAX I can reach ATL, or via from LGA I can reach ATL, if you put this connection, and from LAX I can reach DFW. Now in this graph you can't find any vertex as a cut vertex. In this graph you can find a cut vertex. Now if you remove this vertex, now still the graph is connected. Where it is getting connected? Because of the presence of connection here. So you need to draw a graph in such a way that the graph should always be a biconnected graph without having the given opportunity to get into two graph, to split into two graph. So in such a way you have to draw a root, So if you are able to find any one vertex, that is possible to divide the given graph into two, then that vertex is called cut vertex. So these are all the some important stuff that you need to remember. It may be asked in a 2-mark question or some kind of 1-mark question or MCQ type of questions. So it is not a big one. So what is the, what are the properties of biconnected graphs? The graph should have two disjoint paths. So it should have two disjoint paths. Definitely. Between any two vertices. If you take any two vertices, see if I take PWD and LVJ, so if I remove this vertex, then you should have two disjoint paths, other paths. So that is the condition one. And it should, there is a simple cycle. It should have a simple cycle through. See, if you see, there is a cycle here. There is a cycle here, there is a cycle here, there is a cycle here. So even though it is not a directed graph, without direction also you can make a cycle. So everywhere there is a cycle. So here there is no cycle. Before that, here there is no cycle. Here also there is no cycle. Here also there is no cycle. That's why if you remove this vertex, this graph will become a two different graph. But if you are ensuring that it will have always a cycle, then the graph is a biconnected graph. So in a biconnected graph, it is very highly impossible for you to find the articulation point. So what is mean by articulation point? So articulation point as well as cut vertex as well as separation vertex all have the same meaning. If in a node, if in a graph, if you find a vertex that cuts the two graph into two. If in a graph, if you find a vertex that separates the graph into two. If in a graph, if you find a vertex or if you find a point that articulates the graph into two, so then it is said to be a non-connected graph, and that point is said to be a cut vertex or separation vertex or articulation point. In case if no vertex has been found out, that is cut vertex or separation vertex, articulation point, whatever it may be, if you are not able to find out, then you may clearly say that the given graph is a biconnectivity graph or biconnected graph. So how to ensure that biconnectivity inside a graph? You should ensure that for a node or for any between any two vertices, you should have two disjoint paths. You should have two disjoint paths, and you should always ensure that there should be a cycle between among the set of vertices or through any two vertices in the given graph. If you are drawing a graph like that, then that graph should be a biconnected graph. That means by all means, if you delete or if you omit any connection, the graph will be a connected one, and there should not be any disjoint. There should not be any disconnection in the joints. So that's the idea. Next to these topic, Euler circuit, I think we will see the next class.